Good evening, friends. This evening session is dedicated to class 12, the lesson number chapter 5, Should Wizard Hit Mummy by John Updike. Well, this should wizard hit mummy is a children's story whose theme is about good parenting. See, this story highlights the way parenting is to be done. Parenting is having a greater role in shaping the moral values and the personality of a child. In the story, we find that Jack, the father of Johnny, that is in short Joe, narrates her a story every evening. And right from the age of 2, she has been narrated story by her father. Jack, you know, makes it a custom to narrate a story every evening, and there is a little variation in the theme of the story. Every next story has a little variation, but the theme of the story is almost the same. There is hardly, radical change in the theme of the story. More or less, the story has a little variation with the same theme. So he is in habit of narrating the story to his, daughter, 4-year-old girl, that is Johnny, Joe in short, and that way he is trying to teach her some moral values and moral lesson. He is a loving father, and he finds that it is very important to, teach the young children some values through the stories, and therefore he never forgets to narrate this story every evening to his loving daughter. But what happens actually that in the story is that whenever he starts narrating the story, the young girl, you know, she is very curious. She often asks questions when she doesn't relate any, idea given in the story to it. Then she starts questioning. So, you know, it generally happens that parents often curb the curiosity of the child by, you know, avoiding answering their queries. That is very bad. So in this story, it has been shown that being a child, the girl, Jo, often puts questions and often, disagrees with her father and reasons with him when she doesn't relate the, matter to the story. And that is a very good habit. The parent should encourage the child's curiosity and often, answer the questions in between their narratives. So see what happens, that in the story, Johnny's father told her every evening a story, and it had now become a custom. You know, the story he narrated was having a little variation every next day. And now he started talking about an animal whose name was Roger Skunk. And therefore, he told that Roger Skunk was having a bad smell. So, no animal wanted to be with him. No animal wanted to play with him because of his bad smell. So, he felt very bad because each and every animal hated his smell. And everyone, whoever saw Roger Skunk, ran away. So, Roger Skunk was very upset. So, he went to the owl to ask for the solution of this problem. The owl advised him to go to the wizard for this problem. He went to the wizard. The wizard asked him to bring money. He didn't have the money to pay as a fee to the wizard. The wizard told him how he could, acquire money. And that way he brought money and gave it to the wizard. The wizard next day started telling him that first he chanted certain, magic words, and that all of a sudden he changed his, smell, that odd smell or bad smell, into rosy smell, because, Roger Skunk has desired for smelling like a rose. So all of a sudden, by chanting certain magical spell, the wizard changed his bad smell or the awful smell into rosy smell. Then he started smelling like a rose. He went running happily to his mother. When his mother saw him smelling different from what he was, she became very angry. She scolded Roger Skunk having changed the smell. And she told that one should never, lose the identity. She took Roger Skunk along with her to the wizard. She hit the wizard on his head and asked him to change him and give him his original smell. The wizard did the same. Now both the son and the mother came back home and they were very happy that now Roger Skunk has got his original smell. Now, having finished the story, Jack just, made a pause. Meanwhile, Joe asked the question that should, mom not hit the wizard back because he was changing the awful smell once again from the rosy smell. So he was responsible for having, so she wanted that she should hit him once again so that then the Roger Skunk should get the smell, the good smell back. But then the father Jack, explained to her that look, why the mother and the child both were happy, because one should never lose one's identity. For the mother, Roger Skunk's bad smell was his identity, and she loved that smell. She just found that with that smell, she could acknowledge that it was her son. And when he changed the rose smell, that was not his originality. Therefore, the mother didn't like, to lose her son's originality just to be acceptable to the other animals. And that is why the story teaches us a lesson that one should never try to lose one's identity for being acceptable to the society. And that is what is the theme of the story, that one should never try to change one's identity for being acceptable to others, because one's identity, one's personality is the root of one's existence. And so we should try to, keep it. And the second theme of the story is that we should always try to narrate these young children stories with a theme and values, because that really inculcates in the young children values for the society, values for the parents, and they understand it better. And we should never curb their curiosity. Rather, we should encourage them and try to answer them and satisfy their queries, because that will develop their curiosity, and that will always encourage them to go for logical thinking, and that will bring up a healthy, nurturing. And that is what we call good parenting. And that is all about this story. Thank you. Have a nice day ahead.